happens when God appears on the scene? What happens when God appears on the scene to earth states and the nations tremble? How do we know this? Because we saw the step outside where the Ten Commandments were given to the people. To the people at that time, listen to the Lord. No. How do we know this? Because the author of Hebrews told us they didn't listen. Let's look at Hebrews 12, verses 25 to 27. The author of Hebrews says, be careful that you do not refuse to listen to the one who is speaking. For the people of Israel did not escape when they refused to listen to Moses, the earthly messenger. We will certainly not escape if we reject the one who speaks to us from heaven. When God spoke from Mount Sinai, his voice but now he makes another promise. Once again, I will say not only the earth, but the heaven also, or the heavens also. This means that all of this will be shifted and removed so that only the unshakable things will remain. What is it we need to remember when everything around us is falling apart? What is it we need to remember when everything around us is falling apart? This isn't our home. This isn't our home. Nevertheless, the Lord has made a way for us into this world. How do we know this? Because he made a way for the people of Israel through the Red Sea. Continuing on verses 8 through 15. Was there an anger, Lord, that you struck the rivers and parted the sea? Were you displeased with them? No, you were standing your chariots of salvation. You brandished your bow and your quiver of arrows. You stood up in the earth with flowing rivers. The mountains walked and trembled. Outwards went the raging waters. The mighty deep cried out, lifting its hands in submission. The sun and moon stood still in the sky, as your brilliant arrows flew in your glittering spear flashed. It marched across the land in anger and trampled the nations in your fury. You went out to rescue your chosen people, to save your anointed ones. You crushed the heads of the wicked and split their bones from head to toe. With your stone weapons, you destroyed the teeth of those who rushed out like a whirlwind, thinking Israel would be easy prey. You trampled the sea with your horses, and the mighty waters crowd high. Perhaps right now you feel stuck. Maybe there's a red sea in front of you, a massive roadblock. You're stuck in a class that you wish you could get out. You're stuck on a team where you get no playing time. You're stuck with a label that teaches at school days. You're stuck in a job with a boss you can't stand. You're stuck with co-workers who have no idea what they're doing. You're stuck with a diagnosis the doctor gave you. You're stuck with a mom or dad, brother or sister who just doesn't understand you. You're stuck with a debt that you don't know how you're going to pay. And maybe you're stuck in a relationship or a marriage, like this lady in this opening video, where you don't know what you're going to do next. What is it that you feel stuck with today? I want you to know that God can set you free. Thank you.